Hello and welcome to this video on tokenization. Tokenization is a critical step in natural language processing that involves breaking up text into smaller units or tokens that can easily be processed by a computer. We're basing this series on BloombergGPT. The Bloomberg team used Unigram tokenization. Accordingly, we'll focus on the Unigram algorithm as well as introduce some other tokenization schemes. Let's recall why we tokenize. Natural language models need to be fed numeric data. They can operate on this numeric data during training as they attempt to match a numeric output sequence to a given numeric input sequence. They use the error or loss between the calculated output and the target output to update their internal parameters to minimize the loss. They repeat this feedback loop using backpropagation multiple times until the weights converge and the model generates human-like response to inputs. Tokenization is essential because it allows computers to understand the structure of natural language text and process it in a meaningful way. Without tokenization, computers would be unable to distinguish between individual words or understand the grammatical relationships between them. You can choose to tokenize each word or exploit the fact that many words are made up of component subwords, such as the stems and suffixes shown on your screen. While these subwords don't always follow precise rules, their usage is consistent enough that it would be foolish for your NLP to ignore it. Consequently, some tokenizers will operate at the word level and many at the subword level. There are clearly advantages and disadvantages to both. Generally speaking, word tokenization is easier to implement and interpret, while subword tokenization is more flexible and efficient. Subword tokenization can also learn rare words that are not in the training corpus by being able to infer the meaning of sequences of subwords. You'll hear this called handling OOV, or out of vocabulary words. Here's the word anti-establishment arianism. When broken up into subword tokens, you can see how a language model can easily determine the meaning of this word, even if it has not been specifically trained on it, by making sense of the component subwords. With both word and subword tokenizers, there are multiple different approaches. Several of the popular methods are shown on your screen, each with its own strengths and weaknesses. One popular method is Unigram tokenization, which involves breaking text down into individual characters or letters rather than words. This is the method used by the Bloomberg team in development of Bloomberg GPT. Here's a quick overview of how Unigram works. To find the number of unique substrings in the given sentence, can you get your best bat to play ball? We first need to remove the spaces and punctuation marks and convert all the characters to lowercase for consistency. The modified sentence would be as shown on your screen. The length of the modified sentence is 28 characters. There are n multiplied by n plus 1 divided by 2 unique substrings in a string of length n. So, in this case, there are 406 substrings in total. However, this includes duplicate substrings as well. The Unigram method looks at the probability of a specific token occurring in text. Here we can see the probability of tokens based on the number of duplicate substrings. As this is a very small corpus, you see only a small number of duplicates of more than a single letter, but with a large enough corpus, you'll get many duplicates of common stems, suffixes, and other primitives. Here's a corpus of text, and this corpus transformed into tokens using word-level tokenization. You can make out the words from the original corpus. If we look at the corresponding Unigram tokenization, we see many more components of words. For instance, the token NCE occurs 3 times in this corpus in the words science, intelligence, and concerned. Recall that one of the key benefits of this type of approach is the ability to deal with OOV, out of vocabulary words. This means that at inference time, the NLP AI will still be able to make sense of a word it was not trained upon. Here we see the example of unquestionableness. At its most basic level, tokenization involves splitting up a string of text into individual words. This is relatively straightforward in English, where words are typically separated by spaces. However, other languages may not have spaces between words, or may have complex compound words that need to be broken down into their constituent parts. To illustrate this feature of Unigram tokenization, let's consider an example from Chinese. Chinese is a logographic language, meaning that it uses characters to represent words or concepts rather than letters. Chinese characters can be complex, with multiple components that combine to form a single character. For example, the Chinese character qiong is a single character that represents a range of meanings, including dismay, awkward, or embarrassed, words quite familiar to me. This character is made up of several components, including a square shape that represents a window or opening, and two smaller shapes that represent legs or feet. With Unigram tokenization, we can break this character down into its individual components, allowing us to analyze its structure in more detail. For example, we might represent this character as Wei Tu Chong Ren Ren, where each character represents one of the component parts of the original character. While Unigram tokenization can be a powerful tool for processing text in a wide range of languages, it does have some limitations. In particular, Unigram tokenization can result in very large vocabularies, which can be difficult to manage and process efficiently. To address this issue, many NLP systems use alternative tokenization techniques, such as word piece or subword tokenization, which break words down into smaller units that can be more easily managed. These techniques can also help reduce the impact of out-of-vocabulary words, which are words that are not present in the training data of an NLP system. Despite these alternative tokenization techniques, Unigram tokenization remains a useful tool for processing text in a wide range of languages. It can be particularly useful for tasks like text classification, especially where one encounters rare OOV words or portmanteau words, which often occur in technical disciplines like finance. Hence, Unigram has shown to be a useful approach for Bloomberg GPT. In summary, tokenization is a critical step in natural language processing that involves breaking up text into smaller units that can be easily processed by a computer. Unigram tokenization is a powerful technique that can be used to process text in a wide range of languages, including those with complex morphologies or non-alphabetic writing systems. While Unigram tokenization does have some limitations, it remains a useful tool for NLP tasks like classification or sentiment analysis. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Also consider subscribing so you'll be notified of every video drop from Lucidate.